Ever wonder what makes a DC motor armature spin? To demonstrate this rotation, we only need a few components and apply a couple of rules. Simply stated, a DC motor armature will rotate if current flows in the armature coil and the coil is placed in a magnetic field. When current flows through a conductor, it creates a magnetic field around the conductor. The direction of the magnetic rotation can be determined using the right-hand grip rule. If you put the thumb of your right hand in the direction of the current flow and encircle the wire with your fingers, the direction of your fingers will correspond to the direction of the magnetic field. Based on Fleming's left-hand rule, we can determine the direction of the force on the conductor. With the index finger in the direction of the magnetic field, the middle finger in the direction of the current in the conductor, the thumb will point in the direction of the force on the conductor. Here we see the force is upward when current is flowing toward the viewer, and downward when flowing away from the viewer. The force is due to the interaction between the rotating magnetic field around the conductor and the flux field flowing between the north and south poles. A coil has two sides. Current flowing into the right side of the coil away from the viewer creates a downward force on the right side, and the left side current flowing back towards the viewer creates an upward force on the left side coil. But we need a way to supply current to the rotating armature coil, which brings us to the commutator and brushes. The commutator connects to each coil side, and the brushes ride the comm, supplying current to the coils. When the coil is centered between field poles, the current in the armature coil must be reversed. This will provide continuous rotation on the armature coil. The commutator switches the coil sides at the correct point. So that's it. The armature spins. This is how rotational force is developed in a DC motor. It's perpendicular forces acting on the cylindrical armature coil, not from magnetic attraction and repulsion of magnetic poles. However, magnetic attraction and repulsion is used to create rotational forces on a brushless DC motor and some very, very small salient wound DC motors.